Actually, I would like to invite Sri Raghvendra Prasad again. He's going to present a social initiative and a meditation. So, sir, please come on over to the stage, and I'm going to hand over the mic again to you.
Thank you very much once again. And it's a great day for me. The reason is that today is my master's birthday. I am from Sahaja Marg Ramchandra Mission, and it's happening in Chennai. It's a very, very auspicious day for me to be here, and also it coincides with Maya Yoga celebration. So I think the stipulated time is about 15 minutes, if I'm not mistaken. So 15 minutes, I'll try to complete this, definitely. So I would like to split between the meditation part and what I'm trying to take it as a social service, and the second part. So I would like to talk about the meditation today in the remembrance of my master. So I pray that his grace is always there on Maya Yoga, that it blossoms wonderfully in this universe to heal many, many souls. I make an attempt because meditation is something which cannot be explained, but it can be experienced the way we experienced just now, how the beauty of the yoga coordination is. But still, I make an attempt from my perspective, what I have gone through meditation. So to start with, as a being, a complete being is one who has body, mind, and soul. We have seen a lot to do with the body, but I would rather take in a different perspective, that why this form? Why are we in so many forms? Why millions and millions are being born? The only answer I get from my master is that we are being born with Karana Sharira and Karma Sharira. Especially the Karma Sharira is something which we are being born on account of vasanas, on account of avaranas, which we have created through millions and millions of our journey which we have made in this particular small planet. But what is that meditation then, Asperus? Is it just something to do with the concentration? Is it just something to do with the focusing? I would say it's something beyond all these things from the perspective of our experience, that we have to be as a human being. It is our duty to come out of these avaranas and vasanas so that we don't take karma sharir again and we could become karana sharir in case if the divine will wills. So the best aspect is that maybe at the time of Raja Dasharatha, maybe 22 generations prior to that, a system of transmission started being practiced during that time, where this was little offset during the time of, the Treta Yuga. And in Dwapar Yuga, Krishna preached this again to Arjuna, this transmission. I think what happens during meditation is that it is a single focused approach with completeness. My master gives a very beautiful example that what exactly this single focus completeness. For example, when we start doing sitting for a meditation, always all of us complain that we are being born with a lot of thoughts. Do we have to blame thoughts? Do we have to blame our body because we can't sit for 45 minutes or 1 hour? It is none. It is basically we have lost the touch of our human system to super consciousness. So from this perspective, when we start digging a well, what happens is that first of all, you get the muck, you get the rock, you get many things. By the time when you really dig deep, you get water, that is sweet water. So the same thing happens in meditation, that the before an individual goes the turmoils of various these journeys, I think he will experience many of the disturbances. At some point of time only, he'll be able to stabilize. And this also by the grace of the divinity. So what he says is, anything lesser than a divine energy cannot transform us. It is impossible. No light energy, no any other form of energy cannot transform us. The only source, the source is the supreme source, the divine energy is the only energy which can transform us. I think this has been a great experience of many of the Sahaj Margis today for experiencing this. And of course, this requires certain amount of our dedication and also practice. So the transmission part is something which has been very clearly spelled in our system, that only through proper transmission, through a guided master, we will all be able to set our avaranas and vasanas away from us, and so that we don't have any entanglement. So he says, what should be the goal of human life before starting the meditation? Maybe the goal of human life is basically at least to start with getting rid of these impressions. So the second aspect he has beautifully taught us is that anything we need to put it as a pure form of energy. First of all, we had to take out the dirt. And this is happening on account of cleaning. Cleaning is a second part of the system which we sincerely practice. That cleaning is the one which will take out all the grossness, impurities, complexities, impressions, you can name anything. And these are like hardened parts of our system through evolution of our being, which existed at the center to till today what is happening to us. So cleaning is the one which will facilitate us to take us from the level A to level B. So once we practice this meditation and cleaning, until unless we have this universal brotherhood, we will not be able to have that completeness. I think we also practice at some point of the day, especially at 9 o'clock in the night, that we conduct this universal prayer, so that we emanate ourselves to have that universal love and the embodiment of love to all the species living on this universe. So he says finally that if you do all these things, the last thing and the most beautiful thing which we have to follow is constant remembrance. The moment whatever we do, I mean, he never advised us to leave the job or something. We need not have to retire, we don't have to lose our job, we only have to lose ourselves. Losing ourselves is a form of complete mode of surrendering ourselves to the Supreme Consciousness. This is possible through constant remembrance, and the constant remembrance is the key, is the true key for us to be with this divine touch on a continuous basis. And this is what I want to talk about, a few aspects of meditation. And why I had to take this topic today is so well synchronizing on the day where Master's grace is available to me. And also I pray that this is going to be available to all in terms of this journey of evolution, so that we will evolve continuously. He says, please don't aim for being happy, start getting evolved. Happiness is temporary, but evolution leads towards bliss. So this is what I am also aiming. And this is one what made me think about this most crucial part is service. Because in our system, the service becomes a predominant and integral part of the system as an evolution, so that the individuals can do something to their co-species so that they are also benefited. From this perspective, now I talk something what I have done for next couple of minutes. I don't take much because it will be really good to present, but I don't have much time, so I will only spell it out. I have just recently, about 1.5 years back, started thinking about a system in this universe where most of the deprived people who are seemingly loneliness, we wanted to think about something, that how can we contribute to this universe to remove loneliness. As a part of a small attempt, we founded this Sahabalve. The meaning of Sahabalve is the coexistence of species happily and unitedly. So from this perspective, three things which were kept is that sharing, caring, and love. So service is nothing lesser than a submission of our aspects to divinity. So if we don't do anything without the sharing, caring mode, without love, I think it's as good as throwing something to the people. So needy people pick it up because they don't have a choice, but it's not so. So we have to take it in that perspective. So we formulated three pillars, critical pillars is health, education, and livelihood. I think I also want to thank one more person who is a part of this Sabha Always, Mr. Madhusudan. He is also working in Volvo and a very great spiritualist. We too thought about this about a year back, and this August 15th we'll be celebrating 1 year. The first thing what we thought about is that to create a home for needy where we can really support them mentally, emotionally, in case if economically required also. From that perspective, I have today about 4 to 5 people in a small house. They're all called as Sahab Alvets. After coming there, the beauty of this is after coming there, they're not sitting idle, though they are working. And some people are studying, some people are working. They have all decided to take up few works which they can really contribute to this universe. From that perspective, all of us, now we are not only two, we are about 6 people. The first project what we started about a couple of months back is to take up a challenge of delivering a pregnant woman where she was thrown out of the village due to various reasons. So that lady we got to know through our sources, and finally we made her to come out of a stinking hospital, and we made her to get admitted in a good hospital, and she has delivered a very healthy baby. I think both the mother and kid now gone back to the native. They have accepted them back with our intervention. I think they have started living happily. The basic part here is that not only to support her on that time of pregnancy, but we have also supported her to have her livelihood. I think very soon she is going to start tailoring on her own, and we are going to sponsor even the sewing machine. And the second couple of more projects what we have done is on the livelihood. One of the beautiful things I wanted to tell is that we do so many things on a charity basis to the people who are in the city, but the ignorance of the villagers. An example I'll take, a lady in Ganalu, a village near Kanakpura, she does not know even what to ask because her husband committed a suicide on account of various this loan problems, what is happening every day morning we are seeing, but they could not survive on account of whatever the loans he had taken. Finally, he had to take up an easier route of committing suicide, but she did not even express what to do. And she was only starving for a couple of days. When the information we got, the only thing she said that she can sell some potatoes and onions. We got her this vegetable cart. I think now she has been able to sell these also and making her decent living to whatever she is getting. And her 3 kids, we have started sending them to the school. I mean, that was really a challenging because in the village, people leave the school and trying to support her mother. This is what they wanted, but we somehow motivated. All the 3 kids are going. And a couple of more things what we have done is majorly in the areas of education. We have seen some of the brilliant, brilliant students and the kids coming from a very, very deprived economic situation. One example I would like to cite is that the mother who is working in a mut as a cleaner, she earns hardly about 1,000 to 1,500 rupees a month. Even to stay in a small room itself is a difficulty. But in spite of that, her daughter has secured 92% in commerce, and she has got a seat in the first list in MES. Only thing she had throughout her mind is that whether she can study. I think luckily we have been able to give an assurance that she will be able to, we will be able to support her not only for 1 year but throughout. And like this, we have also supported, irrespective of the caste, creed, and religion, a Muslim girl also who was in the similar need. And the education, I think we have done quite a lot in the last couple of months. At least the 6 to 7 students have got an admission to various colleges. So the aspect what I'm trying to say with these examples is that at the end of the day, what these people are getting is these people are getting some light. At the end of the day, what we are getting is it is fulfillment. I think it's a part of the fulfillment which we are considering that being born as human beings, something is happening to this world. I don't know whether you call it as a karma or whatever it is, avarnas, impressions, everything is happening. But sitting that this has to be eradicated by themselves may be not such a good thing. So learning from my master and my ashram, this is what we took it up and started doing something, reaching to outside. And today, initially we had a lot of difficulties. We had to pile up our own funds, and today a lot of people are coming forward. Only thing is, we started as a passion that's turning out to be a small organization which is going to be registered in next month. I think our main motto is that we support, continue to support in these three pillars, the education, health and livelihood. And we believe that our aim is to have this the support system should be in such a way that it not only gives them confidence but also make them nurture, so that when they come out of this crisis, they should also be able to support to others. So here in this system, we don't encourage supporting for their loans and other things. Instead, we'll show them a way to come out of their delinquencies, whatever they have, through their own system of integrating through the livelihood schemes. And many more projects we are taking up. It's pretty new. I don't want to talk in this forum too much, but it's giving a lot of satisfaction, fulfillment. With this, I end that. Sarve janaha sukhino bhavantu, and whatever possible from our side, we'll continue. We are not desperate in achieving target. Two things which is not there in our company is, we don't have a target, but we have a goal. We don't have a competition, but we have affection. So these are the things which we are trying to follow. With this, I'll close this talk. Thank you very much for Bijaya Madam for giving me an opportunity to showcase this. And thanks to all of you for your patience in listening to this. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Raghavendra sir. Humanity is the highest form of all religions. You have a big heart, sir. Thank you very much for sharing your work for the distress with us. Kudos to you, sir. A big round of applause for him, please. Our next